Dr. Malvika Kapoor, a child psychologist, gives us an introduction to Ayurveda and Kashyapa Samhita, a source book for Kumarabhritya or child care.
Ayurveda has several branches, 8 branches, out of which pediatrics or child care is one. That is called Kumarabhritya. The other branches are Kaya Chikitsa, which is equivalent of internal medicine, Shalya Tantra, which is surgery, Shalakya Tantra, which is what we call ENT, and Stri Roga and Bala Chikitsa consists of obstetrics, gynecology, and pediatrics. They also have Jara Chikitsa or Rasayana Tantra, which is geriatrics, and they have Vajikarana, which is eugenics, which is a preservative. The 8th one is Bhuta Vidya or Graha Chikitsa. Now this is interesting to me because even psychological treatments come under it. That is psychological treatment for adults. But the most interesting part is the pediatrics, that is Kumarabhritya. Kumarabhritya means care of the children. So today we are going to focus on care of the children. And the main text that I'll be following is Kashyapa Samhita. This book also has an alternative title, which is called Vriddha Jivika Tantra. This is unusual because most of the Samhitas, whether it's Charaka, Shushruta or Vagbhata, they don't name the scribe or the person who wrote it down. Whereas this is one Samhita where the actual person who was ascribed to the Samhita gets a title, a name in the title also. Now, very briefly, most of our Samhitas are attributed to divinity. You know, they come down from the gods to people. So, Kashyapa Samhita also has a similar heritage. So, sage Kashyapa, observing through the divine eye and with the blessings of Brahma, created it for the benefit of the mankind. This is what they say about the beginning of Kashyapa Samhita. But what is interesting in this is, he had a 5-year-old disciple whose name was Jivaka. And by the age of 5, Jivaka, who was only a small child, knew the entire Kashyapa Samhita. And this offended the senior physicians everywhere. And they came all ganged up against Kashyapa and said, you can't have a small child being considered a pediatrician. We won't allow it, we have to examine him. Following that, Kashyapa, whether he agreed or not, but they started examining this 5-year-old child. But the most serious part of the examination was that after passing all the tests, he has to enter Ganga and stay under water. And this was probably in winter months, I would assume. And then come out. If he comes out alive, that means he is a survivor. And when this test was given, this 5-year-old child went into Ganga and then came out. And when he came out, he was a great old person. He was no longer a child, but he was an ancient old man. So then all the scholars declared that he is Vriddha Jivika. Now Vriddha Jivika has a symbolism that you could be Vriddha in wisdom or you could be Vriddha in age. So we should assume that the 5-year-old was declared past by the scholars. So, the title is interesting because it is also, Kashyapa Samhita is also called Vriddha Jivika Tantra. So, both the master and the disciple have an equal role in the creation of this text.